Let's go to some.
Good evening. Welcome to Flanagan Park here in Ballinrobe for this historic first streaming of a Ballinrobe GA club game. It's the Mayo Senior Football Championship between Ballinrobe and Aghamore, and I'm joined by two men, one from each club, Pádraig Costello and Adrian Hessian. Adrian, of course, dabbles in the hurling with Turin as well too. Very welcome to Ballinrobe, Adrian. You're going to be an unbiased presence in the commentary box this evening, I sincerely hope.
Thanks very much, Liam, for the first of all the invite down here this evening. It was a great honour to be asked to do this, and from records I think it's the first streamed live Aghamore game. Now I know you've done a few here in Ballinrobe already, but it's delighted to be involved and delighted to be back here in the old stomping ground. I've spent many of the evening up there watching Ballinrobe training. I've been many of the evening watching Aghamore training. It's lovely to be here to be involved in this senior football championship occasion.
Indeed, you're right. It's not our first time streaming a game, because Micheál Cane, who is both the brains and the good looks behind the operation here, has streamed two games recently, the Westport League game and last weekend's Cross Malina championship game. We kept it undercover, Pádraig Cos, because we were coming with the burst below on Cross Malina, weren't we?
Exactly. I think that's where we kicked off our championship campaign, and I hope we can build on it tonight, this evening here in Ballinrobe. The scene looks good. There's no big rain, there's no big wind. The teams look good in the warm-up, so we should be in for a good exciting encounter.
Pádraig, you and I have done lots of games together here over the last 30 years. I say it's probably the first important game we've been allowed to do, because Michael Finnerty has been sensationally dropped from the Ballinrobe commentary team this evening. He has scaled the heights internationally, intergalactically. He's gone everywhere, Cos. But when it comes to the locals, it's the local yokels that turn to yet again, Cos. It's you and me again, Cos.
Yeah, it goes back to the grassroots, where it all began. It's like Mike Denver's song, "Take Me Back Where It All Began for Me."
But give us a bar of it, by any chance?
No, not yet. Maybe at half time, or you know, after, when the if the scoreboard looks appropriate.
Okay, well, we have them all over the world this evening. I hope we're going live. Everything going well there, Micheál Cane. He's a technological genius, Micheál Cane. A big game. The last two times these two teams met in the league, Aghamore were comfortably victorious. However, the last time we met in the championship in Aghamore a couple of years ago, Ballinrobe came with another late burst that evening to win it. Adrian, Aghamore's form was going quite well, but they had a reverse against Cross Malina late on. They were on top for going down the stretch, but got pipped at the post.
Yeah, unfortunately, Aghamore didn't bring their league, their Division 1B victories into the senior championship. They were nipped at the post, as you said, by Cross Malina, 10 points to 9, and followed on that with a match against Ballintubber, which, even though they lost by 4 points, could have won only for two goals just before half time, which they conceded in quick succession. One worry you'd have is that Aghamore haven't scored a goal in their two championship and haven't really threatened. So if they can open up this evening, we could expect a little bit more. Very defensive minded and keep the game very tight as they approach the game. So a bit more open and a bit more forward movement may put a challenge up to Ballinrobe this evening.
I know you have team news from Aghamore. If you want to go through it there, the programme says Neil Welch in goal. I take it he's still there.
Yeah, we'll just run through it. Niall Welch in goal, Kieran Harrison, David Kinney and Jamie Tighe form the full-back line. Fergal Boland, Tom Ford comes through a late scare to play, and Colin Garvey. Kenny Feeney and Alan Freeman, the midfield partnership. Paddy Finnegan at number 10, Robert Lyons at 11, and Cathal Freeman plays at left half forward but wears the number 17 jersey. And the full forward line, Cullen Caulfield, Darren Duffy and Connor Lyons.
You think they're fielding as selected?
Yeah, just the reports back from Austin Kinney there, the selectors, that they're fielding as selected.
Okay, well, I'll go through the Ballinrobe team. I know there may be one or two changes there. Kenneth O'Malley is in goal, one of the heroes of the victory in Cross Malina. The full back line, I think Dara Conway is in at right full back wearing 23. At full back, Eugene O'Malley and David O'Connor left full back. Breaking news there from the camp by Tom Carney, your former neighbour, Pádraig Cos, came with the news there. Half back line, Phelan Riley. David Killian at centre-back and Darren MacDonald, the scoring of the winning point last week at left half-back. At midfield, county player Donald Vaughan, his duel with Alan Freeman will be very interesting this evening, presuming they match up, and partnered by James Murphy. Ballinrobe half-forward line, Joseph Burkett, right half-forward, James Quinn out in the half-forward line the last few games to good effect at centre-half-forward, and Killian Welch wearing number 18 instead of Kevin Quinn at left half-forward. And one further change inside, Sean Burke picked up an injury in Cross Malina, doesn't start. Shane Biggins wearing 2 is listed at right corner forward. We don't expect him to play there. Ronan Macken, two-goal hero in Quas Mina at full forward. And Peter Welch, who got that bullet from left corner forward last weekend. And Cass, when he stuck it, most people said it was like Cass in his heydays when he stuck that goal.
Yeah, he's a very opportunist player. He's low to the ground, and he keeps it low, and he's tricky.
He wears the togs long as well to make him look even lower.
Well,
is that a tactic?
It can be. It makes you look that kind of bit older and more filled out. But he's a smart player, and he knows how to finish.
He was reared in Dunboyne and County Meath, of course. They know their bit about football up there too, Cass. You cross swords with them lots of times.
Yeah, they're tough up there, and it's good that he's down here in Mayo, and it's good to have him on board.
Okay, our referee this evening is Liam Devinney of Ballina Stephenites. I see his umpire's gone out onto the field now. Good crowd gathering here this evening, and really I suppose we should frame this game as being a sort of a game that could do anything, because there's three teams who are vying, maybe even four teams vying for positions in various places, be it getting into the final eight or the relegation. At the moment, as I read it, if there was no game to be played today in the group, Ballintubber would go through on 4 points. I think Cross Malina, whose score difference is at zero, would be second on two points. And then Ballinrobe and Aghamore, both Ballinrobe have 2 points and Aghamore have no point to date, so Ballinrobe will be third. So we hope to keep a track on the in running and what the various permutations are as the game goes on. Basically, both of these sides can go through this evening, and both of these sides could be in relegation battle trouble this evening as well too. So you've got a calculator with you, Adrian. I hope it's one of the latest models.
Yeah, we're just going through it there earlier. All four still in with a chance of going through. Permutations will come into it, and the scores from a clatter up the road will be very important throughout the course of the evening as well. We're expecting Ballintubber, of course, to be very strong, but with already qualified from the group, who knows what sort of a hand they will be showing tonight. Ballinrobe, as we said, have a poor enough scoring average coming into the game, so if Aghamore can get a win here this evening, they'd be looking at leapfrogging Ballinrobe and hopefully picking up a place somewhere along the way in the quarterfinals, or at least avoiding the relegation if needed.
Are more people all over the world watching this evening? There was messages streaming in yesterday.
Yes, there was indeed. Yeah, I can't put my finger on a few and many, but we know that there was a lot of contact from the States, from Australia and from England as well. A lot of our former players, like everywhere else, have moved away to different shores, a lot in Australia, and it's a great opportunity for them to touch base home here with the Senior Football Championship in Mayo, and to get a good look at the locals and the young lads coming through.
One of those people, of course, is Des Campbell, former, or indeed maybe present, and indeed future Aghamore star, who's playing soccer with Mayo this evening. Can't be here, Desi Campbell. A big loss everywhere.
Yeah, Desi, both is still playing with the junior team, still training hard, and still involved in soccer. He's a guy that he really improved as he went over his 30s, and he playing still at a very high level of soccer. So
it'd be something else at 40.
Well, close to 40 maybe than 30 indeed. But we'll see. We might get him back in the future playing. With Aghamore, you never know.
Adrian, you'll put a clock on this game for us, will you? We'll put you in charge of that. Pori Costello, we had contact today from your old sparring partner, Tommy Weakness O'Dool Cameron, in Athens.
Yeah, it was good to hear Tommy again, connecting in. His heart is in Ballinrobe, He may have gone far away, but his heart is in Ballinrobe and in the GAA and how the club are going. And it's great, we have this here this evening that we can stream live out to him, that he can see it. And I'm sure he'll be sitting attentively.
Yeah, I know more than Peter Welch with the togs. The two different socks were his tactic as a player. And he had long togs as well, of course. Some powerful games in the middle of the field for Ballinrobe. For though, alas.
He had, but one thing about his togs, they were very colourful. They might have blue one in one side and he'd have yellow the other, and bits of red and everything, but it really stood out when he was climbing for the ball and catching it cleanly. That's all we wanted to see.
It was the aeroplane O'Shea of Ballinrobe. There they are, the men from Aghamore, coming here this evening to hopefully, in their eyes, secure their first championship win of 2015. As Adrian said, haven't brought their league form into the championship just yet, but so much to play for this evening. Ballinrobe warming up out there as well. Manager Norman O'Brien, I see Donal McCormack and Keith McTighe there. And of course, the Aghamore manager, Jimmy Lyons, a former Jarlitz and Mayo and UCD great, is a former manager of Ballinrobe as well. And I'd say, Porrick, you soldier on a Mayo panel with him in 1981.
Back in 1981, yeah, it was... It was a great year, you know, 81, Jimmy and Liam, both on the panel, great guys.
And now we pause for the national anthem. As we wait on that, I believe we have Niall Murphy out there in Rennes in France. He brought his teammates from France home to Ballinrobe, Porrick, that famous game. The evening that the boys from Rennes nearly beat us here, we had to spring... Who did we spring that evening to win that game? Someone come off the bench. Was it yourself, Porrick? No, Tom Kearney got goal of the decade. Now some people... That's the national anthem. Has it changed?
I don't know how that'll sound in Toronto.
We're off.
Yeah, that's more like it. I like to hear that.
Back again. We had a little bit of a two runs at the national anthem there, but all goes well. It's be interesting to see how they line out. Porrick, you'll keep an eye on the Ballinrobe team. Adrian, you'll see do Aghamore line is selected. I see Shane Biggins going into right corner forward for Ballinrobe, but as we said, we don't expect him to last too long there. Ronan Mackin is going to left corner forward, Peter Welch at full forward, and we have Killian Welch at left half, is the present and correct. Half back line looks as selected, and the full back line, Dara Conway, of course, in at right corner back, with Shane Biggins gone up the field. Eugene O'Malley is at full back, and at midfield it's Freeman and Feeney. Feeney was Kenny Feeney, of course, well known hurler as well. He was very effective in the league game when we met earlier on this year. So, first battle between Vaughan and Freeman breaks to Donald Vaughan. They're county colleagues, of course. Vaughan charging through, free for Ballinrobe. And up comes Kenny, a good man to kick a free. Porrick Costello, he's had a good run of it in the last few years, kicking frees for Ballinrobe.
Yeah, Kenny. Kenny is good. You know, he takes his time over it, and he gets the distance, and you know, he's always there or thereabout. You know.
So just on the 50-yard line, straight in front of goal. Well within his range. It's a blustery evening here at Flanagan Park, Ballinrobe. If you see over there in the embankment, you'll see the long grass is billowing away. It'll be a difficult kick for Kenny. Taking a short run, hoping to keep control on it. Seems to, it just tails left and wide. He got the distance all right, Porrick, just a little bit to the left and wide, but it's a kind of an evening a kicker would have to get his eye in anyway, wouldn't he?
Yeah, the breeze seemed to have caught that one there at the very end. So, you know, the breeze could be tricky down in that corner. So, things you have to watch out for.
Okay, Aghamore on the attack. This is Kenny Feeney, strong player. Alan Freeman, another strong player, coming through the middle. Robert Lyons coming short and getting it. Putting it across to the right corner back, Kieran Harrison, I think it is, up in attack. Lyons again. Long ball inside to Colm Caulfield. And Robert Lyons again, they're setting it up at Aghamore, back to Kenny Feeney, sells a nice dummy, James Murphy buys it, Feeney going through, but a misplaced pass comes to Shane Biggins, as we said, named to play at right corner back, started right corner forward, but we expect him to play a more defensive role. Across to Ronan Macken, long term midfielder for Ballinrobe, playing full forward in the winter of his career and having a great season, has a lot of injury troubles though. There's something off the ball there, and I think that's Dara Conway or Killian Welch who's down for Ballinrobe, so a chance for everybody to catch their breath. Aghamore patient in their build up there, Adrian, but didn't penetrate, and a final pass went astray then.
Just a change in the makeup of the Aghamore team. I suppose Fergal Boland not playing in his conventional where he was picked at right half back. He's picked up a position at right half for him, with the number 25 coming in at right half back for Aghamore. Can't identify who he is at the moment with the change.
Okay, and that's a yellow card for we think it might be Paddy Finnegan that got that yellow card. We'll wait for, I think it's like Robert Lyons' shape and make, as they say. David Killing attacking for Ballinrobe. He did the same frequently last weekend. Yes, that card was for Paddy Finnegan, a yellow card for Paddy Finnegan. Donald Vaughan trying to get past Alan Freeman across the goal, intercepted. Joseph Burke for Ballinrobe. Peter Welch in there foraging. James Murphy meets Tom Ford, and Ford collects. Out to Fergal Boland. Aghamore attacking now on the River Robe side of the pitch. Boland intercepted by Dara Conway, former Castlebar Mitchells player, working locally in Ballinrobe in the Lakeside Sports and Fitness Centre. James Murphy. Eugene O'Malley, far from home. Donny Vaughan. Joseph Burke. Ronan makes a run to the corner. He gets a lot of space. I think that takes a tumble. And he looks in bother. He has had a lot of injury trouble over the years. He seemed to come down very unfortunately there. He looks to be in a lot of pain. And Porrick, that would be a huge blow for Ballinrobe. And personally for Ronan as well. I mean, he has suffered so much from injury.
Yeah, he seemed to come down very awkward there on his leg that time, and I just feel it could be the worst. I hope I'm wrong, but I just seen his leg kind of bending underneath him, you know.
Okay, well, that's a very unfortunate start. That's going to stop play for a few moments. Hopefully, it's not as bad as it looked originally. He was not being challenged in any way when he went down, and the Ballinrobe medics coming on the field now. Hello to Niall Murphy, I said, in France. We've other people listening as well. Tony Walken in Tupper Curry, former Ballinrobe captain, captained the club to the Mayo Intermediate title. Tuned in as well, too. And if you've other anybody else listening, feel free to put a message up on our Facebook page or our Twitter account or text Micheál Cain or myself or Pori Costello or Adrian Hessian. And we'll give you a mention there as well, too. James Bradley is listening in Kansas. Pori, you played with James Bradley. He's in Kansas now, the man from Cahir.
Yeah, I'd like to say hello to him, James, a good, honest player, a good lad, and a great member of the club.
Indeed, and keeps a very close eye on the fortunes of the club, and his niece, Grace, was the young lady who designed the club logo for the Robe Rockets recently, so the Bradley name still continuing in Ballinrobe GAA circles.
It still carries on, yeah. Well done to Grace. You know, she's a great little girl, and, you know, well done.
Okay, the good news is Ronan is up on his feet again, and he might be able to soldier on, it seems, although he does look very... very ginger on it. He's a player who is far too familiar with injuries right throughout his career, indeed. He's been a superb servant of Ballinrobe GAA Club, one of the best fielders of a ball in the county.
Yeah, and he got two great goals against Cross Malina, you know, no later than last Sunday, so he's important.
So here come Aghamore, Kieran Harrison. Kieran Harrison, fine kick, it's going to travel, and it travels over the bar first goal of the game after 6 minutes. Kieran Harrison with the point, and it was a fine kick, Adrian. Very, very confidently kicked.
Funnily enough, he'd done the same against Ballintubber in the last round of the championship, coming up from corner back to kick an excellent point. We forgot to mention earlier that his brother Brendan Harrison out suspended today after receiving a straight red last week. So Kieran definitely made up for it there with that lovely point from Dale.
Okay, off camera, Ronan Macken unfortunately has left the play, and in is David Murphy, number 17 for Ballinrobe. 1 point for Aghamore. No score for Ballinrobe. Ballinrobe on the attack. Darren McDonald, a good kicker of the ball generally, puts that one up high. But it tails off to the left and wide. A second wide for Ballinrobe, Porrick. Struggling to get their get the range in there, Porrick.
Yeah, well, that was a very scorable chance, you know. And we need to take each of these as they come, you know. To be in here with a chance. It's going to be tight, so we need every score.
Aghamore building again. Darren Duffy, very promising young footballer for the last number of years. Darren Duffy, scoring sensation at various stages of his career. Alan Freeman arcs a beautiful ball into the corner where Cullum Caulfield is out to it ahead of Dara Conway. Caulfield, big strong man. Fergal Boland, Freeman calling for it. Darren Duffy back to Alan Freeman on the right boot, and Alan Freeman puts that one over as well. And he got one beautiful point last Sunday in Ballintubber from the throw-in, where he took it one-handed, soloed straight through and put it over the bar. A settling score for Aghamore, that one.
It's a good start for Aghamore. 2 points on the board already, playing well with the aid of the breeze and picking up the points. Alan plays a different role for Aghamore than you'd see him playing with Mayo. He's usually on the edge of the square, but he's a ball-winning midfielder and a carrier for Aghamore.
Ballinrobe building again. Eugene O'Malley to James Murphy. Murphy to Donny Vaughan. We believe it's close between Donegal and Derry. We must get an update on that. Oh, what a kick from Donny Vaughan. And that was 50 yards, Pori Costello. After 8 minutes, Ballinrobe, 1 point, Aghamore two.
That was one great point. You know, if Alan Freeman can do it at one end, so can Donny Vaughan at the other.
Great score for Ballinrobe. They needed that. They had attacked quite a bit since the start, but hadn't threatened the umpires with the flag, and or to use his flag rather than with the flag. No, this is all well intercepted by David O'Connor, always a good man to read how the play is going to go. David Killeen, oh, loose pass, Darren Duffy, and he returns the compliment. Shane Biggins getting a little bit scrappy now for Ballinrobe. He used his body to good effect there, might well have fouled the ball, but he got there. Phelan Riley to Donny Vaughan. Donny Vaughan trying to get forward as much as he can in this game. Ground appears to be a little bit slippy. Donny slipped there. Phelan Riley to James Murphy. So, of course, Ballinrobe no longer have their target man full forward, Ronan Macken, in there. That said, when he went off last Sunday, Ballinrobe got some good scores. Last Saturday, Ballinrobe got some good scores. David O'Connor joining the attack. Darren McDonald. David Killeen. Gets around Robert Lines. David to Shane Biggins. Is there a man on his shoulder? Shane can't get it to a Ballinrobe man. And Aghamore can tidy up. Paddy Finnegan. Tom Ford. Alan Freeman. To Connor Lines. But it's a line ball. There was good pressure from Killeen Welsh, but a line ball for Aghamore. We have 10 minutes gone here in Flanagan Park, Ballinrobe. Aghamore 2 points, Ballinrobe 1 point. Kieran Harrison and Alan Freeman getting the Aghamore points, and Donald Vaughan getting a 50-yard point for Ballinrobe to bring it to 2-1. It's free for Aghamore. The referee, is he going to his book? I think it was James Quinn was involved there, Porrick.
Yeah, it seems to be James. He's actually talking with James at the minute. I didn't see it, but is he going to get a card? He has got a yellow
card for James Quinn. Latest viewing figures: 790 people already online watching this game. I didn't check the text in a few minutes, but they were flowing in earlier on. Kenny Feeney, free scoring as a hurler. strong coming through here out of the left foot. Under a lot of pressure, he had worked very hard to get that score. Adrian Hessian was a very good point because he'd come through some heavy tackles.
Yeah, Kinney is a great ball carrier, low centre gravity, pulled through the middle. That's 3 out of 3 for Aghamore. There's good return rate from any shots taken so far. A good start for the Aghamore side.
Yes, they'll be happy with that. Aghamore, 3 points up, 2 points up, 3 points to one. Ballinrobe, slow build up again. David O'Connor, James Murphy, Donald Vaughan, Joseph Burke, but there was something off the ball. I think he has penalised Donald Vaughan or James Murphy perhaps for carrying through. I don't know if it's Alan Freeman he engaged with, but it's a free for Aghamore and in the hands of the former Mayo minor player David Kinney, very accomplished fullback. Aghamore playing a possession game. Darren Duffy. Darren Duffy has a free kick on the right foot. Kicks it well, and after 13 minutes, it's now 4 points to one for Aghamore. And Pádraig Costa and Ballinrobe need to get a foothold here.
Yeah, they need to get a grip in this game now. As Adrian has said there, that's 4 from 4. You know, Ballinrobe has came up to the 30-yard line there a few times, but there was no score from it. So we need to finish.
So Aghamore in the driving seat at the moment. Alan Freeman fouled. He wants to kick it quick to Fergal Boland. He does. And Cathal Freeman, Mayo senior by times and a great minor in his day in Croke Park for Mayo, into Fergal Boland. He's getting forward a lot. Oh, great interception by David Killeen, and Ballinrobe really needed that because Aghamore were building up ahead of steam. Donald Vaughan, David Killeen, Joseph Burke run, but it's 2v1. He does well to come out to it. Can he get it in his hands? Just didn't get to gather it. James Quinn gets in, but taken off him by Colum Garvey. Robert Lines. Darren gets back, referee waves it on. I think it might be an advantage. Darren Duffy puts it to Colum Caulfield. Caulfield versus Eugene O'Malley. Eugene trying to keep him away from the danger zone. Good pressure by Eugene. James Murphy, but Cathal Freeman is solidly built, able to withstand that challenge. Back to his namesake, but not a relation, Alan Freeman. Tom Ford. Cathal Freeman. Fergal Boland, just a little bit too precise that, and it runs through to Donald Vaughan. 4 points to one. 14 minutes gone here. Aghamore, 3 points ahead. Ballinrobe have lost Ronan Mackin, their target man full forward, the scorer of 2 goals last weekend, gone off injured, and are struggling to link play between the middle of the field and their attack right now. Darren Duffy. Pressure from Shane Biggins. Free, says the referee. Duffy's going to take it quick. Not allowed to do so, and it's been brought forward by the referee. Robert Lyons has the ball in his hands. Fergal Boland makes a run. Inside to Colum Caulfield again. He seems to be playing at full forward, even though he's wearing 13. Caulfield back to Kenny Feeney. Feeney steps inside, kicks high, drops, and Kenny takes it underneath the crossbar. It just ran out of juice at the last moment. Shane Biggins. Sorry, Dara Conway. Peter Welch, our first chance to see him in action. He's lively, good young player, being shadowed by Jamie Tighe. Peter has made ground, he's still going. Can he offload it? He can, to Joseph Burke, another young player. Joseph Burke inside to Shane Biggins, left footed and over the bar. 15 minutes gone. Ballinrobe 2 points, Shane Biggins kicking it, Aghamore 4, and Pádraig, Ballinrobe needed that one.
They certainly did, Liam, and I'll put that one down to Peter Welch. He was out in front, he held it, he took his man on, got inside, laid it off, and a great point.
Into the first quarter, it's still a very competitive encounter. Tom Ford now for Aghamore. Jamie Tighe. And yes, as Pádraig said, great work by Peter Welch for that last Ballinrobe score. Colum Garvey to Robert Lyons. Back to Garvey. Fergal Boland. I think that's Paddy Finnegan coming through. Robert Lyons. It was very tight though. And Ballinrobe could recycle it. Ballinrobe had the advantage of the breeze, Adrian, I would say.
Yeah, the slight advantage seems to be with Ballinrobe in the first half, all right, even though they're not fully making use of it at the moment. Aghamore, every time Aghamore go up, they do look very, very dangerous, as we can see another Ballinrobe attack coming through.
Okay, this one is running inside to Joseph Burke. Joseph does well to gather it. He has a shot off his left foot, perhaps. And yes, he's got that one, and that was a good score. He hesitated for a second, but he shouldn't. He's an accurate player.
He's an accurate player, Liam. You know, there was a big improvement on Joseph there. The first two balls he got, you know, into him, he misjudged them or whatever. But that's good, and that'll do his confidence good.
Absolutely. Latest score from Clogher, the other game in this section. 3 points apiece between Cross Malina and Ballintubber. And that would... We have an abacus here to try and sort out what that would do if the game ended up. Well, if Aghamore win here today, they'll be on two points. That would put Cross Malina and Ballintubber through. If that score stayed the way it is, they would put Cross Malina onto three. It'd leave Ballinrobe on two. But it's too early yet for that. And Adrian Hessian is not great on the mats this evening, Adrian. I think it was it past sums?
Yeah, it's a long time ago now as well, no more than any of the rest of us here. But we'll deal with that when the time comes.
So, Aghamore on the attack again. They're getting a lot of space down the right wing. And here they come again. It's Conor Lyons. He didn't hold on to it. The ball is getting greasy. There's a fall of rain there as well, not helping things. The ball is getting greasy. It's hard to maintain control. And Aghamore didn't add to their tally there. It looked promising for a moment. 4 points to three. Ballinrobe have inched their way back from being 4-1 down as the crowd make for the stand because the rain is starting to come down. Donny Vaughan. Oh, good interception by David Kinney. So the linesman has given that one to Aghamore. It's an Aghamore line ball right at their own dugout. And they build again. Fergal Boland, he has been, I would say, the player most in possession so far this evening. This clear Aghamore have a special role identified for him, Adrian. He's been freed of his defensive duties, I think, to get forward.
Yes, he can be played as a very attacking-minded player as well. A very, very fit athlete who gets up and down the field, hurling and football, very, very fit. And he just seemed to have picked up a knock here, along here. It'd be dangerous for Aghamore to lose a character like Fergal having coming in. He was replacing Brendan Harrison, who we spoke about that.
So he was a direct replacement for Harrison.
Direct replacement. He didn't start last week against Ballintubber, but did influence the game when he came on.
He has certainly filled in the Harrison role of carrying from defence very effectively this evening. He looks like a man who's been very settled in the team. So there's it's Boland again. Boland coming across is Shane Biggins. He's come back out. There's two Aghamore men down injured. A man from each team down injured. I didn't see it, Porrick. Did you see it?
I didn't see it either. The ball had gone. I'd say they just clashed into each other.
It's getting greasy out there now as well. Players are carrying into tackles a bit more than they might like.
Yeah, there's a thick mist falling here now in Flanagan Park, and it's making things very slippy, and you know, it's changing the game somewhat.
4 points to three, Aghamore leading. 20 minutes, we're in the 20th minute here at Flanagan Park, Ballinrobe, and it's Darren McDonald that's down for Ballinrobe. I'm not sure, have you seen
It could be Kenny Feeney that's down, another influential player for Aghamore. Kenny started off well there, getting a point from play, and has carried a lot of ball. If he's down injured, it's a big loss if he has to go off injured.
Big loss to Thurin as well.
Indeed, my other capacity, I always come to these Aghamore matches to keep an eye on our dual stars in the parish. We have four starters here on the Aghamore senior team who also started in the county senior hurling final last year. We have David Kinney at fullback. We have Colin Freeman in the forwards, Fergal Boland, and Kenny Feeney, of course, as well, who's down injured at the moment. So big loss all around. Notable from this game, with 20 minutes on the clock here already, all scores coming from play. A real open game of football. Not much fouling, not much cynical stuff in the full back line of either team. Forward sort of on top, getting through, getting their shots off, and it's lovely to see.
We can report that Harry Murphy is here. Harry Murphy is here, Pauly Costello. That's a boost.
I wonder has he his gear with him.
So now, Darren McDonald is back up. I don't know, was it definitely Kenny Feeney? That it was Kenny Feeney. He's back up as well, but he's not moving very well yet. We'll have to keep an eye on that. I think Darren was kind of shook as well too. Kenny Feeney on the ball. David Kinney, another one of the hurlers. Tom Ford on his shoulder. Kenny doing well to hold on to possession under extreme pressure. He's pulled for over carrying. A little bit of afters. That free didn't go the required distance, so it'll be taken again. Joseph Burke giving it to Eugene O'Malley. Dara Conway. Fouled by Cahal Freeman. Joseph Burke. Phelan Riley with a bit of work to do, but no major panic yet. Back to Joseph, but he's going to be challenged. Phelan got it back. It was a little bit lucky there for Ballinrobe. Punched away by David Kenny, but he called Colum Garvey, I think, for a late tackle perhaps on Joseph Burke. I think he played the advantage, we think, and he brought it back for when advantage didn't accrue for Ballinrobe. Joseph Burke, James Quinn. Taking on Tom Ford. Quinn is speedy. Can he hold control? The ball is very greasy.
Well done, Dave.
David Murphy recycling to James Murphy. David Killeen. Shane Biggins. David again. Right of a kick off that one, Porrick. Travels well, but just left and wide. 22 minutes gone here at Flanagan Park, Ballinrobe. Aghamore leading by 4 points to 3 in this third round of the Mayo Senior Football Championship. And as we've been saying, it's a very greasy evening now, and ball handling getting increasingly difficult, Adrian.
Yeah, I suppose the tone and the speed of the game has totally changed since we had that shower there 5 or 6 minutes ago. It's become a more difficult, more slippery game now, with a lot of mistakes accruing for both sides. Notable as well, the Aghamore set up when they do go on the defence, all their half forward line funnel back into the half back line, creating a whole blanket defence, and it's hard to get through for Ballinrobe as we've seen so far.
Okay, no wide for Aghamore. They've been very economical. Ballinrobe have 3 wides, thanks to statistician Tom Kearney for that, and Patrick Hindley from the Connacht Telegraph. Darren Duffy to Fergal Boland. Patrick Hindley, of course, he'd be resolutely unbiased this evening here, covering Ballinrobe. Darren McDonald, David Killeen. Slight turn in affairs coming in terms of possession, it seems. David Killeen getting forward again, lots of space. Alan Freeman coming to meet him. Nice ball inside to Peter Welch. He has the turn. He's coming through, shoots, and goal. The Meyer, his second goal in the week, Porrick. He only started his first championship game for Ballinrobe, his first ever senior game for Ballinrobe last weekend. He's done it again,
and there's no better man than Peter. He's low to the ground, but he keeps his shot low, and he found the net with much ease at that time. Great lad.
Beautiful finish coming off the right side. He hadn't a lot to aim at, but he stuck it past the Aghamore goalkeeper, Neil Welch, and Ballinrobe take the lead for the first point time this evening. 1-3 to 4 points. Ballinrobe 2 points up. And they're sensing they can get something from this spell. Donald Vaughan coming across. Great goal from Peter Welch, as we said. Raised in Dunboyne, moved to Ballinrobe with a young man, and stuck a beautiful goal last Saturday against Cross Malina, and repeated the dose there again today. Ballinrobe 1-3, Aghamore 4 points. The latest scoreline from Ballintubber after 28 minutes from Clahar is Cross Malina 5 points, 4 points for Ballintubber. So that would force a major purchase of abacus, or whatever the plural of abacus actually is. Abacai. Thank you. So Aghamore coming again, and they're coming down the right wing. It was Colum Garvey that came in there, and a beautiful point, I think, from Colum Caulfield that stuck that one. We'll have to check that one in a moment. I think it was Colum Caulfield that got that one, and that puts it 5-1-3 with 26 minutes gone. Not 5-1-3, Ballinrobe 1 point to the good. Darren McDonald. David Killeen working very hard this evening. David Killeen getting on a lot of ball, who's involved in the build up to the goal. Shane Biggins. Shane kicks, and Shane points. That's his second point. We said he wouldn't play in the attack because it's not his position. He's a defender, really. But he has got forward from that deep-lying role he has around the middle of the field, Porrick. He has got forward a lot.
He has, yeah. And that was a great score, you know, for a cornerback with his right foot. Now, he often kicks at his left, but that was a special point.
1-4 to 5 points. Ballinrobe lead. A turnaround. The goal from Peter Welch giving them a real shot in the arm. Aghamore coming again. More urgent that they get scores now. They had a lot of play earlier on, and they're now trailing by 2 points.
Come on, goal again, goal.
Alan Freeman. Well intercepted. Well done by James Murphy. Got the hand in. And James Quinn now in possession for Ballinrobe. Into the corner. Peter Welch going for it again. Peter Welch in shadow by Jamie Tighe. What'll he do with it? He overplays it. He did two bounces. He got caught between two minds, Porrick. And on the second bounce, he was going to kick, but he ended up bouncing it. And he'll be learning, though, because it's hot stuff out there now.
Hot stuff. He was just waiting for someone to make the run, and he just couldn't make up his mind. He plays a good bit of soccer with Galway United, and, you know, sometimes you get...
Yes, yeah, indeed. Now, Aghamore on the attack again. Darren Duffy to Alan Freeman. Freeman wins it well in front of David Killeen. He tried to go through, I think, Dara Conway rather than around him there. He may have lost his footing going into the tackle, but Ballinrobe come clear again. And this is a good spell from Ballinrobe, Porrick.
Yeah, that was very good. Twice there, Alan Freeman tried to break through, but twice he was dispossessed. So Ballinrobe fairly tightened up in the back.
David Murphy beaten in that race for possession by Kieran Harrison. And out here it comes to Cathal Freeman. Cathal Freeman, a player troubled by injury since his minor days. What a minor he was. Showing some good signs here as well. Good to see him back playing football. Freeman again, old beautiful touch turn there as well. Fergal Boland. And that's a really good point from Aghamore, and that'll give them a bit of a boost, Adrian.
Yes, just before half time, we have 27 minutes on the clock, and Fergal Boland with that fine point after a long run of the wing here in front of us by Colin Freeman. Just to confirm, Colin Caulfield did get that one earlier to make it 5 points to 1-3. Then Shane Biggins came in with his second score to make it 1-4-5, with Fergal Boland there just bringing it to 1-4-6 points to Ballinrobe still.
And Aghamore kicked what? One wide or no wide?
We haven't
still no wide. Still no wide. Is that a tactic?
That's a tactic that all teams should have.
So now, Aghamore coming again, looking to get something before the interval. That was Conor Lyons. Killian Welch is down, injured for Ballinrobe off the ball. He collided with his own man, Shane Biggins, we think, and Shane looks a little bit bothered after it as well. The referee is going over, and... Yes, so a chance for everybody to catch their breaths here. It's been a very entertaining first half, and it's been Aghamore were leading all the way through until the 24th minute when Peter Welch struck for that brilliant goal. And really he has been an enormous addition to the Ballinrobe team these last few weeks, Porrick. People would have probably thought he was a little bit young, might take a little while to come, but when he made the burst these last couple of weeks, he has been sensational.
Yeah, he's just what Ballinrobe needed, you know. He done the exact same thing in Crossmolina, you know, when the going was tough going and it was tight, it was Peter who stuck that goal, you know, just to give them that breathing space ahead. A great guy, great lad.
Okay, well, still down injured, unfortunately, here. Alan Freeman, meanwhile, is placing the ball right on the 50-yard line for a free for Aghamore. He's not letting that one go. And the rain is coming down very heavily now. We've got a huge crowd here now. You can see them gathering in the stand. I see Rory Kane there, former Mayo Minor captain and intermediate title winner with Ballinrobe. And lots of greats all around the place here this evening. Tommy O'Malley, hope you're listening this evening. Tommy, your old sparring partner, Porrick, your old colleague for 80 or 90 years, I suppose you played together, the two. He had an unfortunate accident in the US. But I think he's home, and I think he's listening. Our viewing, watching, I should say. So, Porrick, you stood by him for many years.
Yeah, Tommy, he's a great, you know, he's a great man for the game, and I just like to wish him well and a speedy recovery. And you know, I know his heart to be. Would love to have him here this evening, but Tommy, we're ahead, so things are not too bad yet.
I'd say he'd be hard to sit beside on the couch this evening. Now he'd be trying to play away with the broken leg and everything.
Yeah, he could be swinging. I just hope he can keep the bad leg quiet. I hope he's on his left.
Okay, indeed. One of the greatest men ever to wear the Ballinrobe jersey, Tommy O'Malley, played for Mayo for many years as well, too. And we still have that Killian Welch injury bringing us into injury time. We will have a bit added on after that, I would say. And the, as I said, the rain coming down heavily, the ball is very going to be very greasy now. We've had a largely dry spell in the last few days, certainly up until the last few days. The ground will be quite hard overall. In fact, I think the ground may have been watered during the week. It doesn't need much watering this evening, Borek.
No, it's getting a nice drop of rain there, but as you said, it'll be greasy on top. My main concern there now would be for Killian Welch. You know, this is his second time going down injured in the course of this game. So, you know, I just hope he's okay.
He's back on his feet. There's David Colleran, Ballinrobe man who, up until a few years ago, was living in New York, back in Ballinrobe now. Fergal O'Malley there as well, and his young son Louis, I think, that's with him there. Killian is back on his feet, but there's still some concern about him. And Adrian, as we go into injury time, will be a few more minutes in it. It's all to play for.
It is all to play for here. It's a nip and tuck all the way, and the score is coming through from Clahar as well. It's nip and tuck up there all the time. I think we could be in for an extended amount of injury time. We had a lot of bad injuries, Ronan Mackin to Kenny Feeney, and now Killian at the moment down injured. So we could be looking for 5 or 6 minutes of injury time here.
Back on his feet, Alan Freeman has stolen a yard, and Darren McDonald is protesting that yard. It's a bit like the field, Porrick, isn't it? The Bull McCabe.
Could be a vital yard, you know. It could be the vital yard. Time will tell.
Well, let's see. Alan Freeman, a prodigious kicker of the ball, of course. Mayo panellist and regular starter for the last number of years. Burst onto the scene in the final year of John O'Mahony's reign, if I recall correctly,
2010 against Sligo. He made his debut and burst onto the scene, scoring a goal and a point in the first five minutes.
We lost the yard, Porrick. We lost about 25 with it, I think.
Definitely 25. Yeah, it must be descent by one of the Ballinrobe lads.
Darren McDonald didn't retreat quickly enough, and Alan Freeman, this is very much within his range, and this would tie it up. This would tie it up if you were to kick it. But it is a difficult evening for kicking. That ball is greasy. That ball could go off the boot very badly if he didn't connect properly. He gets it sweetly, and he gets it over the bar. A leveler for Aghamore, Adrian. Good recovery from the jolt of the Ballinrobe goal.
Yeah, good recovery, and just a notable one there. The first point at three of the game, and again, we're nearly in the 33rd minute, and no wides yet for Aghamore in this particular game.
Okay, Kenny O'Malley with the kick out, targeting Joe Burke. Phelan Riley stays down. It breaks out here to David Murphy. David probably does the wise thing, because there wasn't much chance of getting into his hands where he was. He would have slid out over the line. Kenny Feeney. Paddy Finnegan, the right half forward. Kenny again. Kieran Harrison, point scorer earlier on. He is bowling on his shoulder. So the jersey pulled, he got away with it. It's David Kenny. David Kenny was very good in the league game earlier on this year. Cahal Freeman seems to be working inside now, in closer to the Ballinrobe goal. David O'Connor has been under a lot of pressure, and Ballinrobe break up the play again. Kieran Harrison, three in for Aghamore. And I think we've had another bit of descent and brought the play in again into another scorable position. That's a boost for Aghamore, Adrian.
Yeah, the same discipline by Ballinrobe has rewarded Aghamore. This is their second ball brought into a more favourable scoring position. Alan converted it easily there just a few minutes ago. Can he repeat the feat? He got 2 points already in this game, one from play in the 8th minute of the game, and the second from the free just there in the 33rd minute. We're now nearly in the 35th minute of the first half, and this is to put Aghamore 1 point in front.
So, Alan Freeman to kick this one. This would put Aghamore up. I see Norman O'Brien, the Ballinrobe manager, on talking to Darren McDonald. I think he was the player involved, the bits of descent there. Alan Easy strike over the bar. Aghamore take the lead. We're in the 36th minute of the first half. Aghamore take the lead again, 1-5 to 7 points. Am I correct in that? 1-4 to 8 points. My mistake, 1-4 to 8 points. And Pori Costello, well, we'll follow the player for a moment. But Aghamore will be happy with that, Pori. They got a bit of a rattle from Ballinrobe, but they're back ahead again.
Yes, but I didn't like there, you know, Aghamore got the last two points from descent from the Ballinrobe there. And, you know, that's not good enough. We give away two simple frees that were brought in, you know, especially the last one, without on the sideline, 14, 21 yards up, in a scoreable position.
Okay, the halftime whistle is gone. We went to exactly 36 minutes. 36 minutes played. Aghamore retire, 1 to the good, 8 points to 1 goal and 4. And I think we're going to go through the half-time, Micheál. We'll keep going straight through. We might get some people up to talk to as well, too. I see Tom Carney, the former club chairman here. We'll talk to him, maybe some of the press members here as well, too. But first of all, Pádraig, your final thoughts from a Ballinrobe perspective there.
Yeah, I thought it was good enough first half. But, like Aghamore had didn't have any wide in that game, you know what I mean? And they have 8 points on the board. So, like, Ballinrobe need to start getting more scores and, you know, putting them away. It's all to play for. Tight, close, very hard to predict.
Yes, indeed. 8 points to 1-4. Aghamore a point up. And Adrian, I think he'd have taken that about 6 or 7 minutes ago, or 10 minutes ago.
Indeed, when Shane Peter Walsh came through for that goal in the 23rd minute, followed closely by Shane Biggin's point, it went 1-4 to 5. And it looked as if Ballinrobe were going to get up ahead of steam. But back into the game with Fergal Boland and Alan Freeman with the 2 points to bring that to the front.
I think that's Sean Burke on crutches this evening. He played last weekend in Cross Malina. Conor Kane injured as well, and team mentor Martin Welch. And the score lines from around the venues, we'll get those to you in a moment. But I'm going to talk to Tom Carney, the former club chairman, first of all. Tom, Ballinrobe chased the game, not usually so, but we're behind for a lot of it. Came with a great burst to get the lead, but have surrendered it again.
They have. I mean, the conditions aren't what you would call conducive to football. It's more of a chasing game at the moment. The ball is slippery. There's a lot of mistakes being made on both sides, to be fair. Aghamore a bit more clinical when they get inside our own 45, conceding 2 frees and then giving away the advantage when they weren't as easy to make as they could have been. If we get the ball inside to Joe Burke and Peter Welch, especially, he took his goal exquisitely, turned on it on a dime and took it in, and really, really, if we can. Losing Ronan Macken was a big loss.
Huge loss.
A massive experienced player, been a fantastic servant to the club. But Peter Welch, who's come on the scene this year and has really taken his chance with both hands, and he's got 2 goals in 2 games, as you mentioned. And if we can get the ball in him, I feel with his pace and his goal making, we're still in this game. There's only a point.
He plays with great confidence.
He does. He plays for the minor team the same way. He plays for Galway United the same way. He's been like that ever since he was knee-high. Well, he's still knee-high to a grasshopper. But at the moment, he's putting his skills to good use. He's a very low centre of gravity. He's very hard to tackle. The player that's marking him is literally half his size, so it'll be an interesting second half of football.
Okay, the crowd this evening, Tommy, you're saying is about 600 people here this evening?
That's the official word from Alan Flannery, our chairman, who was on the gate with James Waldron, the ex-county chairman from the Neil, from our neighbourhood parish. So 600 is a fantastic turnout given the conditions.
Okay, well, this is a very intimate evening here in Ballinrobe, and all the best intimate videos include something from the cameraman himself. So Micheál Cain, what do you think so far? You can put it out there on the pitch. How are we fixed there? Micheál, of course, played for Mayo, won at Sigerson with NUIG, and also won intermediate titles and a few untitles with Ballinrobe. And Micheál, what do you think so far? Ballinrobe going okay, but when they got ahead, perhaps could have stayed there.
Yes, Liam, I suppose, you know, they just seem to be lacking the that kind of edge that they seem to have in the Cross Malina match. They seem to be kind of starting and stopping a lot, so they just seem to be able to push on, maybe get past that barrier a little bit more and drive on. The game is there for them if they do that, I think, myself. But
okay, well, it's going to be a very interesting second half. I'm going to grab Adrian Heshin again as well, too, to come in. Now, we're just going to take a look at who's in touch from around the world. Wiggy, around the world. Wiggy is in Athens, as we said earlier on. And we have the Lions is in Chicago. We have Sean Shocknessy in Chicago as well, too. Dave McDonald. Paul Tiernan is out there. Not in Chicago now, I hasten to add. Tommy Jennings, former Ballinrobe player. Christy Burke watching live from London. Very entertaining commentary, says Christy Burke. Well, thank you, Christy. And we have various other people around the world watching this evening. But to go back to Adrian, as we said, Aghamore go in point up. What impact do you feel the conditions will have in the second half?
Well, the conditions, I suppose, will have a bearing on the game in that Aghamore like to carry the ball and carry from deep, and that won't be very conducive in weather like this. They tend to build their attacks from the half-back line and move forward at pace, and so it becomes trickier and trickier in these situations. Easier to defend as well with the one-point lead for Aghamore as well. They'll be looking to hold that point lead and move forward. Slight breeze here, but it's sort of blustering and circular rotation, not really favouring anyone in particular. So we're looking at sort of getting on top as much as we can throughout the course.
So just half time here, I suppose, if anyone's joining in. Teams have gone in about 7 or 8 minutes now. We'll be back into the game again. Score again is 8 points to Aghamore, 1-4 to Ballinrobe. Tight match. Peter Stanton is to my left here on the tweet board, so if anyone needs live updates and they can't get this stream, I suggest you check out the website and Twitter. So Liam is looking a little drenched here beside me.
Yes, indeed. We had to attend to some running repairs out there. I think it's Daniel Carey from the Mayo News available there for a moment. Daniel, almost a veteran scribe at this stage, although he's still only about 27 years of age. Covered lots of games. And Daniel, your impressions on that first half?
It's been interesting, Liam. I felt the first took Ballinrobe a while to get into them. I was about to take the blame for that myself. I've yet to see a South Mayo team win in the senior championship this year.
You're the problem.
I think I am. That's what I was told this evening anyway. I've seen Claremorris lose in Ballina, so Kilmaine and Shrewd and Corrib lose on home soil last week, so everything seemed to be going according to plan, so to speak, for the first while until Peter Welch stuck that goal. Looked like Ballinrobe had got back the whip hand again. Obviously Aghamore came with those couple of late frees. As I see it, as things stand, if Crossmolina win, neither of these teams actually will qualify. Crossmolina obviously will join Ballintubber on 4, and that, by my calculation, that would also mean that Crossmolina would actually finish as top seeds. Obviously if Aghamore win this, Ballinrobe would end up in the relegation playoff. As you mentioned at the start, there's just so many varying permutations. A point either way obviously could make a huge difference. As the lad said, it is getting slippy, and conditions are I'm sure difficult out there. I'm glad to be in here rather than out there.
Well, it's an even for the press box, Johnny. Thank you very much, Johnny Carey of Mayo News. Patrick Henley from the Connacht Telegraph is going to join us in a moment as well too. I think it's the Connacht Telegraph you're on duty for this evening, Patrick, is that right? And also the Western people this evening as well too, of course, the Ballinrobe man. Patrick, what do you think?
Yeah, I suppose good first half to say from Ballinrobe overall. They scored 1-4 and took the goal very well. I suppose just a small bit of indiscipline there towards the end of the first half with the referee bringing forward those couple of frees. So apart from that, I mean, you know, Ballinrobe are doing quite well.
Is that a special issue, Ballinrobe top, or is it Portugal?
Sponsored by Portugal, so it's a new one.
We'll take what we can get. Peter Stanton is here as well. He's our board and old chairman. And up until maybe, did you play last year's championship, Peter? I don't think you did play last year's championship, did you?
No, I played a couple of league games last year. The last game against Bunnycundlem was my last outing for Ballinrobe GA.
You're our man on the Twitter updates this evening. What do you think so far? Not of the Twitter updates of the match.
Yeah, well, I'm doing an apprenticeship here under you today, so it's not too bad. It's hard to actually watch the game when you're doing this, but it's an enjoyable game. It's tit for tat, really. It's unfortunate now the last two frees Ballinrobe conceded, really as a result of dissent. Hopefully they learn from that in the second half. And really, it's all about getting the ball into Young Welsh and Joe Burke. They're really kicking on in there. But again, they're going to have to stop Aghamore building from the back. They're really, every time they build, they look dangerous. So if they want to win the game, they're going to have to stop that and get the ball in early.
Your brother Jim, is he watching this evening somewhere overseas?
Jim is watching live in Dubai, I believe. I sent him a WhatsApp there a while ago to let him know to get the link. So, Jim, how's things?
Okay, very good. We have a few more people we're hoping to get in a few moments' time. I see Rory Kane there, but I think Rory Kane's he's charging for interviews now, isn't he, Michal? He's charging, I think, since he retired. He's charging. There's about 600 people here, as we said, this evening. Big crowd here from Aghamore as well, too. And I see John Joharan in from Galway there, Galway Football Board official. They're of course, will be out in backdoor duty. Any results from around the country, lads, this evening? I think 7-4. Donegal are trailing Kilcommon at half-time. Donegal are already qualified in the Intermediate Championship. They're 2-4 to 7 points down. Stephenites beating Ballinhadreen 6 points to 4. That's good for Ballinhadreen Stephenites. Hollymount, come over, Tom. You can go live. Hollymount leading Swinford 8-3.
Just to, checking the Twitter updates here, just trying to find where they're all going. In an important game for Kilkenny GAA, the British Junior Final, 10 minutes to go. Kilkenny are 1-7, Scotland are 7.
They're beating the country.
They're beating the whole country, Kilkenny. Now, that's a massive achievement for Kilkenny. I know they've had some big achievements, but I think beating an entire country is a new one for me. Just as I say, scrolling through, trying to find...
Out of Derry, Donegal. Do a search.
Half-time score... Castlebar Clamars is 1-9 to 6 to Castlebar Mitchells.
Donegal are leading, are they?
They are, yes.
Donegal are leading, okay.
The referee is blowing his whistle.
Okay.
3-1.
3 points to 1. I met a man before the game, told me Donegal and Derry were leading at half time, but I thought the game hadn't started until 7 o'clock. Yeah. 6 all. Restarted in Clare. 6 all. Not restarted here. Are they going to come out at all here? Are they worried about the weather here, Adrian? Are they afraid to come out in the rain?
I think so. I think the long evenings or the long delays before halftime, they're getting extended halftime here, both teams. I suppose talking a bit of tactics, they both want to win the second half and come out very strong. The first couple of scores, like in all games, are going to be vital, and it will put a stamp on the game as the half develops out. Just funny you were saying about a whole country there a while ago, but a lot of these guys that Aghamore are feeling tonight won an All-Ireland Division 2 fail back about 6 or 7 years ago, and they beat New York in the final of that particular, so plenty well able to put it up against the big populations around the Aghamore guys anyway.
Okay, very good. Mary Langan is here. Mary, of course, now living in Ireland, but you'll hear from the accent. She's not born and rare, but she's very Irish from her time in New Jersey, Mary, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it, Liam.
Who do you want to say hello to?
Everyone, well, geez, I want to say hello to Joe Langan, Mike's brother in New York, working at one of the Irish pubs out there, and all my friends and family in Long Island and New York, New Jersey.
Are they all watching?
Of course they are.
You were in Hollymount this morning with the ladies' football team. They're coming along nicely.
Yeah, brilliant. The under-10s won. Under-12s just lost by about 2 points, but it was brilliant. Great day. Great to see them out playing.
Are Claire and Mikey here this evening?
Yeah, they are. Claire's down next to me. Mikey's out with the lads.
Are the club colours on?
Of course they do.
Okay, very good, Mary. Thank you very much. Mary Langan, thank you. And Aghamore are back out. And here come Ballinrobe, led by their captain, Eugene O'Malley. And we are in for a very interesting and important second half, Pádraig Costello. Adrian Hesching, you're on the clock again.
You know, with a slippy evening, you'd be expecting goals to win. You know, there's going to be mistakes made with the long ball. Anyone that puts in the long ball today, I can see mistakes being made in there. And if you get a cute corner forward like Sir Peter Welsh, you know, he could stick another goal.
So they could dart in handy enough for a little touch home, couldn't they?
Exactly, yeah.
It's all about the dart in, isn't it?
It's all about the move in, yeah, move in fast.
And out a quick two as well.
Oh, yeah, out for the kick out, yeah. Exactly.
Okay, have we any changes? Killeen Welch is still there. I see Peter Welch coming out talking to James Quinn. David Murphy is in the Ballinrobe full forward line, along with Shane Biggins. Joseph Burke, for now, is out on the half forward line, but I suspect he may venture in towards goal when the game starts. There's a number 23 in the Ballinrobe defence. That's Dara Conway. He was there in the first half.
Just to note that Aghamore run changed from the first half, all 15 present and correct. For the second half, Paddy Finnegan, number 10, even though he's lining out a corner forward here, I couldn't find him in the corner field, but he's over here in the corner. I don't think he'll stay there too long. He'll be funneling back in front of the half-back line as the match starts.
Okay, well, we'll try to keep you posted on events in Clare as well too, because that is a huge bearing here. And as I think Danny Carey said, if Crossline were to beat Ballintubbard, that would mean both of these teams could not progress to the quarterfinal, and one of them would be in relegation trouble. So it's a bit like the last five countries voting in the Eurovision, Pádraig.
Yeah, I think that Ballinrobe match, I think Killian O'Connor is to come on in the second half, and there was talks on that. So if he does, you know, that score could change round. I think it's all down to the wire here.
Ear to the ground as always, Pádraig Costello. Now, to get back tuned into this again, Connor lines for Aghamore. Caulfield moves left of goal, Fergal Boland back to lines. It'll be hard for him to get that. Davy Killing didn't spare him in that one, and David Murphy is there trying to go in for Ballinrobe. It's very scrappy now. A function of the weather, it must be said. It is a very greasy evening. David Alan Freeman, Kenny Feeney winding up, didn't go for it then. That's Cahal Freeman. High kick in. Colm Caulfield is underneath, he's tall. But David Killing there yet again. And Pádraig Costello, David Killing has handled a world of ball this evening.
Yeah. David is back to his best, with the Ballinrobe team at the minute. So I just hope he can keep it going now. It's tiring out here this evening.
Thanks to Margaret Killeen and the Elaine Mackin and Marion Mackin for the halftime cup of tea. Much appreciated by the media corps here. James Murphy, effective tackle. Tom Ford for Aghamore. Strong in possession. Fergal Boland is screaming for it. He's got a yard on Darren McDonald. They go down the left wing instead to Darren Duffy. Duffy turns Phelan Riley. Foot pass to Boland. Some of the momentum taken out of that attack. It looked promising for a moment there. Playing around little triangles over there. Long ball here across to Connor Lines. Killian Welch, rugby player as well. Connor Lyons gets into a kicking position. That's a beautiful kick. And that puts Aghamore 2 up in the third minute of the second half. Beautifully arced kick there by Connor Lyons.
Yes, Connor Lyons showing his versatility. He's playing at right half back, but he drifted up the right hand side and a lovely point into the teeth of the breeze. He's just informed here by Tom Kearney, just for the eagle eyed viewers out there, Ballinrobe have changed jerseys at half time. They were wearing an orange coloured jersey in the first half. They're now in their usual maroon wine coloured jersey.
Spotter's badge for Tom Kearney, I have to say. Spotter's badge. Now, Shane Biggins, Donald Vaughan, powering through the middle. The man who went to ground was his county colleague, Alan Freeman. He gets a hand on that one, though, and that's an important interception. Freeman now. Tom Ford to Darren Duffy. He's setting up a lot of the play for Aghamore. He's not always associated with being that far out the field. He's a score getting forward as well. And they're coming in waves now. Robert Lyons. Was an effort to call Freeman, but there was interception there, and Ballinrobe averted the danger. David O'Connor, Phelan Riley, Joseph Burke, James Quinn, trying to find his way out of this corner, but it's getting tighter by the minute. And it's a line ball for Aghamore. 4 minutes gone in the second half. Aghamore 2 points up. 1-4 to 9 points. Adrian O'Malley, greetings to you. You're watching, I think, in London. I met your brother, who's home for the weekend, the other day. And here comes Ballinrobe. Peter Welch to Shane Biggins. It's a foul on Shane Biggins. And it's a free in for Ballinrobe, 21 yards out, and almost from nothing, Pádraig, Ballinrobe conjured up a chance there.
Yeah, out of nothing, and again, it was the long ball that went in. But, you know, we lost two balls there. Just
it's a chicken quickly, we'll just go back to the play. Throw ball.
That one was for, he wasn't 13 metres away from the intended.
Is that a hopped in, the punishment, or was it a throw ball?
He has awarded a free out to Aghamore for that discretion.
There was no panic there, Bart.
There was no panic. You just had to take your point. Simple stuff. You were 21 years old. You didn't need to get a goal. The goal mouth was packed. Why not do the simple thing?
Alan Tubber now leading by a goal. So we're back to where we expected to be in terms of this being a shootout between Ballinrobe, Cross Malina and Aghamore. That's as things stand now. Adrian Hessian has the logbook open now. He's going to get into full mathematical swing any minute. Einstein was his nickname in school. We're hoping it'll... Pythagoras, they called him. Alan Freeman. Cahill Freeman. Good tackling by David O'Connor, but Cahill Freeman tidies it up. There's not much space there. Ballinrobe pressurising hard. They might get a break on this one if they keep working on it. Darren Duffy. Adrian O'Malley has the feet up in London. I think he's got a few bunions on the feet. If you look on the Facebook page, there's a few things on the feet not so healthy looking, but he's watching it live in London. Colm Caulfield. Kieran Harrison coming through outside of the right boot. It's an ambitious effort. Doesn't get it. It'd take an Andy Morden job, that one.
You got a great point. In the first day, I would have run like that, you know, like something similar, but he was just wide in the mark that time.
That was Aghamore's first wide, we think. David Killing gathering again. David Killing having a great game for Ballinrobe, having a great last few weeks indeed. James Murphy fouled by Kieran Harrison. And David standing over the free. All our forwards are out at the 50-yard line at least. James Murphy is ghosting in. Will Donnie popping in long. James is still calling for it in the right corner. Coming to him now. Is anybody working off him? Oh, the footing just lets him down. And Aghamore can tidy it up. Yeah, he had nobody with him, Porrick, there. He got into a good position.
He got into a perfect position, but he just didn't have the help. When he went to ground, there was no one there to take the ball off him, you know, and that's three or four chances that's gone in there, and we got no return.
Okay, the score now is Ballinrobe, 1 goal and 4 points, Aghamore, 9 points. 8 minutes gone in the second half, and Adrian is going to tell me in a moment, if the game finished now, who would go through, who would go where? And Fergal Boland on this attack for Aghamore. Good tackling there. Great tackling by Dara Conway. Well robbed there. And David Killing comes away with it for Ballinrobe. Donald Vaughan. Greetings to Michael Harness listening this evening. I think it may be in Galway. I'm not quite sure. Killian Welsh. Killian could give it to Darren. Darren just gets a knock just as he's about to kick. He's a good kicker off the ball, Darren. Back to Darren again. Shane Biggins. Left foot is high. Who's inside? Peter Welch. He's not exactly Kieran Donaghy. And Aghamore can mop it up again. Good block by Shane Biggins, but could only half parry it away. And Jamie Tighe has it for Aghamore. Aghamore quite good on the possession game, it must be said. Building and building again, Aghamore. Alan Freeman, he's been their leading light for quite a few years now, has always tended to play well against Ballinrobe. Cahill Freeman. Cahill, left footed, right footed, soloing with each foot, kicking with the left. Kenny gets a hand to it, but it goes over, and that makes it, by my reckoning, 10 points for Aghamore. 1 goal and 4 for Ballinrobe, and a little bit of a gap opening up there, Adrian.
Yeah, a little bit of a gap developing now. That's 10 points, 1-4. Ballinrobe haven't scored since the 27 minute. We had that long extended period of injury time, and we've had 8 minutes of the second half now.
We're back to the play. Darren Duffy. Darren Duffy has Boland on his right. Fergal Boland coming through, and inside is Colm Caulfield, and a great ball back again to the on-running Alan Freeman, and the county player finishes to the net, and that's a big score. That's a big score, Adrian Hessian, because as we were just saying, they were opening a bit of a gap. Now they've gone 6 clear, and that's a very decisive score.
Yes, lovely move there by Aghamore. Really cut through. As I said, they were good ball carriers into the tackle. Colm Caulfield combined well, saw Alan Freeman free, and that's Alan's 1-2 now for this game. That puts a nice bit of daylight between the two sides. It's 1-10 now for Aghamore, 1-4 for Ballinrobe, and we have 10 minutes on the clock here in the second half.
And Ballinrobe have lost Dara Conway to a black card, and already depleted resources will be stretched even further now. Pori Costello, we haven't scored for 19 minutes.
No, it doesn't look good at the minute now. Right now. That's the first goal that Aghamore have scored in this year's championship, and it could be the most vital one they will score.
It looks important that Ballinrobe get back scoring again very soon, because it's not an evening that scores will come easily. The ball is greasy, it's a heavy evening. Matthew Burke is replacing Dara Conway. I think, I presume Shane Biggins has gone back to field. You might check that for me, Porrick, with Matthew Burke in the attack. Now, Donald Vaughan trying to get around Kenny Feeney. Killian Welch. James Quinn. The Ballinrobe central forward, former Mayo Minor. I think he hopped it twice there, but he's back to the referee. And he got a score. James Quinn in Ballinrobe's long scoreless spell. On 41 minutes, James Quinn makes it 1-5 to 1 goal and 10. What news, Adrian Hesham, at the moment?
Just a confirmation there from Daniel Carey. I think this result stands as they are at the moment. Aghamore have leapfrogged both Cross Malina and Ballinrobe and hold second place on the table. So it's topsy-turvy all the way to the end.
And they hope with Ballinrobe in a relegation playoff. Okay, so... Referee judges that tackle by Kieran Harrison and David Murphy to be a foul. Here's Joseph Burke. Matthew Burke is inside as well. Kinney's coming up to kick it. So it's, as I said, now a 5-point lead for Aghamore. And you get the impression that every score Ballinrobe can pick off Porrick would be hugely important. Every chance they get must be capitalised on.
Every chance, and we just have to watch for any like dissent, that we're not like giving away a silly freeze or you know, or giving yardage. Every ball is vital from here on. You know, keep picking away.
Okay, well, this is the first effort they have, about 47 metres out according to the line, but it's further, of course, because of the angle. Kinney takes a short run. Beautiful kick, it's going to drop short, but what happens when it does drop? Broken away by an Aghamore hand. I think it was Paddy Finnegan who has picked it up at the second time of asking and has won a free out. And that's a disappointing one for Ballinrobe. It was an ambitious enough kick for Kinney to get. It would be a huge score to kick. But I think Paddy Finnegan did good work there for Aghamore.
Paddy Finnegan, he funnels back in front of the half-back line. In fact, all the Aghamore half-forward line working back in defence, and they move at speed from here.
He'd be a brother of the great Sean Finnegan, of course.
Yeah, Sean managed Aghamore there for a few years there, a couple of years ago, and Paddy be a younger brother, surely.
Former Mayo Minor captain Sean Finnegan, he might be listening somewhere up the country this evening or watching somewhere up the country this evening. Carl Freeman running to this, but the ball beats him to the line, and Ballinrobe, David O'Connor to Joseph Burke, a long way from home. James Murphy, David O'Connor back to Murphy. Good play by Ballinrobe. Eugene O'Malley, the fullback, nephew of Tommy aforementioned David Killeen. As you can see, Aghamore conceding some space to the likes of David Killeen and dropping back into defence to invite him on. David still carrying, powerfully strong man to Donny Vaughan on the right boot. It's a good angle for Donny, but it doesn't come around. And another wide for Ballinrobe. And that's Ballinrobe's first wide of the second half, I think.
But yeah, first wide of the second half for Ballinrobe, but fourth in total. But I've noted there, Donald Vaughan, since he got that point for Ballinrobe in the ninth minute, hasn't been in the game much and has been kept relatively quiet. But he popped up there and had a lovely chance to score, but just drifted to the right and wide.
So the kick out for Neil Welch goes short to Kenny Feeney, to Tom Ford. Any updates from around the venues, lads? We'll give you them if we get a few there. National or local, indeed. That's good work there by Peter Welch. He forced the kick from Colm Garvey. And Colm put it out over the sideline. Donald Vaughan will kick it now. Deep inside. We're not getting much inside at the moment, Porrick.
No, we're not. That's twice now we weren't on the breaking ball, you know. We need James Quinn more on the ball, when it goes in around there. You know, he's one of our danger men.
Fergal Boland to David Kenny. Kenny across to Darren Duffy. He has Connor Lyons to his right. He uses Connor Lyons. Tackled and fouled by Joseph Burke. It was probably more high than... probably looked worse than it was, Porrick, but when you tackle that high, the referee is going to take notice.
Yeah, it was a bit awkward of a challenge, and there mightn't have been like that much need to do it, you know. But we're giving away that free again, so everyone that we're going to pay a price for, you know, at the end.
So Three-quarter mark reached. Aghamore leading by 5 points, 110 to 15. Alan Freeman stands over this free. Around the grounds, Ballymount Caramore 8 points, Swinford 3 points. That's in the intermediate championship. We're in the senior championship here. Alan Freeman just short of 50 yards out, straight in front of the goal. He's been very impressive all evening. This one comes off the upright and goes wide. So no change in the scoreline. Still 5 points up for Aghamore. Ballyhadrine are gone a point ahead of Ballina Stephenites, 8 points to seven. Down are leading Wexford, 15 points to 12. Louth are leading Leitrim, 10 points or 8 points to 6. And Joseph Burke has beaten Colum Garvey to the ball. He has James Murphy on his left. He goes it alone. He has Donald Vaughan coming through just off his fingertips. Couldn't get his hand on it. And Aghamore drive on. Darren Duffy. It's one-on-one here. It's read beautifully by Carl Freeman over David O'Connor. Carl Freeman inside to Caulfield. And well blocked and saved by Kenny O'Malley at the expense of a 50. It was Colm Caulfield, I think,
Colm
that time.
Colm Caulfield that was on the end of that move through by Carl Freeman. But in fairness to O'Malley, he smothered him well. Possibly the wrong man in the wrong position. If it was the other way around, we would have expected a good finish. But O'Malley got down well to save at the feet of Colm Caulfield.
How often have we seen Kenny O'Malley save Ballinrobe like that? He did it last weekend in Cross Malina as well, with a brilliant save from Brian Benson. And I think he'd won great save in the first half from Finan Duffy as well too. But Aghamore have another chance. This is a 50. Just a few yards out from where Alan kicked a few moments ago. 5 points apiece. Derry, Donegal, 5 points apiece. Interesting, as they say. Alan Freeman. Kicks again to the left and wide. And I suppose, in fairness, Porrick, it's a difficult evening for long-range kicking because you're trying to control it with the greasy ball, and it's hard to do it right.
It is, yeah, but that all came from a bad pass up here. We were, about 40 yards out from goal, and a bad pass by Joe Burke to Donald Vaughan coming through the middle. And if that had came, Ballinrobe should have got that score.
Matthew Burke, another misplaced pass intended for Donald Vaughan, didn't get there. And Aghamore come building again. And this is Darren Duffy, shadowed by Phelan Riley. Duffy's had a huge influence on proceedings this evening. He's handled a huge amount of ball. Robert Lyons, Duffy. And Ballinrobe, yes, won the free. He was a bit unlucky to fall, but once he went to ground, the onus was on him to do something with it, as long as the Ballinrobe lads didn't foul him. And they didn't. Joseph Burke with the free. David Killing urging Ballinrobe to drive forward. And good evening to JP O'Gorman. Not sure if you're here this evening or not, JP. I know you've been tuned in a bit on Facebook, so good evening to you as well. Great soccer player Darren McDonald with the right boot, and it goes out to the right and wide. An uncharacteristic miss by Darren. Mitchell's 2-11, Clamorris 8 points. A red card for a Clamorris player, Mickey Mullins, we believe. And Caspar Mitchell's good form holding up there as well. Adrian, Aghamore in the driving seat?
Yeah, in the driving seat at the moment, with the results the scoreline coming through from Ballintubber, it puts Aghamore in second position in the group and in a position to qualify for the quarterfinals.
Oh, high tackle by Tom Ford. Just the locals don't like it. It was high on David O'Connor.
It has to be black.
Murray Costello, referee. It'll be black. Ballinrobe continue with the play, but they won't be allowed to do that. Black card, correct call by Pori Costello here, and it's Tom Ford will depart the scene. Not sure who's going to come in. Adrian might give us a steer on that. Good evening to Ronan Curran, the well-known Davids GA Club secretary, tuned in this evening over there in Ballandine. I think it's tomorrow they're playing Ballyhaun, isn't it? David O'Connor, beautiful kick by David O'Connor, and that might give Ballinrobe in the 49th minute the shot in the arm they need, Pori.
Yeah, that was a vital score. That was a vital score to get them back in contention. You know, and they keep picking off their points like that. You know, like this game is here for the taking all the time. Especially with Tom Ford going off there now, kind of, you know, like the middle might be a star.
Okay, so Aghamore have a man on. We're going to check who it is in a moment. Keith Cassidy is the man on for Tom Ford. Connor Lyons. This is Aghamore building again. It's Cathal Freeman who's come back to the field to help out. And Ballinrobe, Shane Biggins intercepts. David O'Connor, Darren MacDonald. This is better from Ballinrobe. MacDonald to Murphy and back to MacDonald. Inside to Peter Welch. A long way from goal, but he's plucky and he's bold. He's dancing and trying to get through. Gives it to James Murphy. He kicks with the left foot. And that's good as well. And we're back to a 3-point game here. 51 points, 51 minutes, James Murphy with a point, 1-7 to 1-10. Porrick, the last three scores, by my reckoning, have come from Ballinrobe.
Yeah, and you know, I think last week against Crossmaline, Ballinrobe finished strong also, so maybe this could be a good omen for them.
10 big minutes coming up. Ballintubber cantering on in Ballintubber, they're leading 2-10 to 7 points. Ballinrobe enjoying a good spell. James Quinn to James Murphy. James Murphy got the last point. Bottled up now though, needs to use it and lose it, as they say, and he's lost it. He got sucked into the challenge there and couldn't get out, Adrian.
Yeah, he did indeed, but Ballinrobe, as we say, are going through their purple patch. They've got 3 points in succession now. Aghamore need the next score to keep themselves in front and keep that daylight between the sides.
So Aghamore come again. This is Connor Lyons inside to, I think it's Caulfield. No, it's not. It's the left half back, Colum Garvey. Back to Connor Lyons. Coming in along the left wing. Kicks with the left boot. It'll be a great point. He's the umpire is pointing. Yes, it's Connor Lyons, I think. It's difficult to see in the fading light, but it was Connor Lyons confirmed, Adrian.
Yeah, Connor Lyons picked at right half back, but playing at a left half forward position and covering every inch of this Flanagan Park here today.
Okay, so we're at 1-11 to. So I think we're a short one. Yeah, 1-11 to 1-7. It's a 4-point game. Ballinrobe got it back to 3. They're sticking at it. They stuck at it last week in Cross Malina, and it bore fruit. Will it do so this evening? Aghamore, an accomplished side. Aghamore, very good at carrying the ball out of their own defence. I'll probably put the hex on them when I say that. Alan Freeman, Paddy Finnegan, Colum Garvey. They're taking a lot out of it back there, but they're confident. David Kinney. Out to Jamie Tighe, Kenny Feeney,
David Kinney,
yes, the fullback attacking up the field. He was a fine male minor fullback a few years ago. Oh, Cathal Freeman dances inside. Beautiful ball inside to Fergal Boland. He has been a threat to Ballinrobe for most of the evening. He fist passes that, and Adrian, that gives a bit of breathing space. A 5-point lead back to Aghamore in the twinkling of an eye.
That's the lead they need going into the final stages of this game. Aghamore showed their characteristic movement up the field into the danger area, and a lovely fisted point by Fergal Boland.
We're told that Killian O'Connor and Alan Dillon have both come off the bench for Ballintubber. As Porrick said at halftime, that could have an influence, and it has had an influence. Peter Welch to David Murphy. David Murphy back to Donald Vaughan. Donald, oh, what a fantastic block by Alan Freeman. And Aghamore come away. Inspirational block there by Alan Freeman.
Yeah, a vital block. A vital block at a vital time.
Fergal Boland is in attack, Porrick, just one moment. And Fergal Boland with another point. That makes it 6 points, and that could be very important again.
You know, for me, Kenny Feeney has his hand in nearly every score that Aghamore has got. He has played a fantastic game around the middle of the field.
Yeah, and he has dropped back to help the defence and take short kickouts, and he's been very solid for Aghamore. Into David Killeen, who's now gone into full forward, and Ballinrobe are going to go for the route one approach, I think, in the last 5 minutes. We saw him playing back in Turmakidi one evening. If David Prendergast is listening, or indeed his brother Prinder Brendergast, you got a bit of a do and money even back there, Porrick. But you were famous in Turmakidi yourself, Porrick. That was where you coined the all we want is justice ref.
That's right. Yeah, we had some great days in Turmac. And
the Gael Threerden.
The Gael Threerden Cup.
Okay, we're back here at the senior championship this year. We'll go back to Turmakidi in a moment. Here comes James Quinn to David Killeen. Can he get it back to James Quinn? He gets it to James. On the left foot, low. Ooh. It wasn't far away. It was a bit ambitious, Porrick.
A bit ambitious. Well, you know, he was a good bit old. Maybe we keep taking our pints, you know. There's plenty of time, you know.
We have just over 5 minutes of normal time to play. It won't be as many stoppages, we suspect, unless something else happens now, Adrian. It's a fewer injuries in this half.
Yes, it's more open, more flowing in this half. There's not as many stoppages in the game as beginning to develop. 6 points between the sides, as you said, and if the result goes as planned for Aghamore in Ballinrobe, they're in a good position at the moment.
That would put them into the quarter final and Ballinrobe into a relegation playoff. Here comes Darren Duffy. Darren Duffy has oceans of space. He drops the ball, perhaps at too much space, and gets robbed of it by David O'Connor, but Ballinrobe making heavy weather getting out of there, and it's back in Aghamore hands again. Matthew Burke comes in, Alan Freeman comes off the upright. What's going to happen? There are two Aghamore men down. Referee, I think, has called it back. I think he gave advantage and called it back. And we are on 25 minutes 48 seconds. Time ticking away. Aghamore have eased themselves into a comfortable position, and this stoppage now, the first serious stoppage of the second half.
Yeah, I think we put the curse on the stoppages. There's three Aghamore men and one Ballinrobe man down at the moment. It could be a while to tidy up the debris out in the field at the moment, but Aghamore won't mind. They'll want to burn down the clock now. It's just 4 minutes left officially on the clock and whatever stoppages are left for stoppage time. But I must say, I have to commend the Aghamore ball carriers in the second half. Kenny Feeney, as Porrick has said, has driven up the middle numerous times. Darren Duffy playing in a different position out from the goal. His usual space is around the edge of the box. He's carrying ball into the attack, as is Cathal Freeman and Colm Garvey as well. But Ballinrobe still have a chance to get back into this.
We'll just go back to the free, Adrian. Thank you. It's Ail Alan Freeman with the free. And that's a point. It is a point indeed, and that puts them
1-3 for today.
That's 1-3 for Alan Freeman. Thank you, Adrian. That puts them, I think, 7 to the good now, and that looks unassailable. It looks unassailable, but you never know. Long ball into Big Davy, but it's too long, and it goes out for a 50. Come off, I think, Paddy Finnegan's hands there, and it's out for a 50 for Ballinrobe. And Kenny's coming up from his goal mouth to take this 50. Will they go short? Of course, they still need three scores to level it, so you might be as well have to try and put it over the bar, Morrick.
Drop it in, whatever. Goes over.
Full time, 2:16 to 9 points, Caspar Mitchell's beating Claire Morris. Full time, Ballintubber 2:11, cross the line of 7 points. Kinney gets that one, it's back to a 6-point game, and it's we are in the 28th minute of the second half. So just to recap again, Ballintubber 2:11, Cross Malina 7 points. Winners take all here in our book then, I think. And Mitchell's 2:16, Clamorris 9 points. We hope to get something on Derry Donegal and Hollymount Caramore versus Swinford in a few moments. But back here at Flanagan Park in Ballinrobe, a particular word of thanks before we forget at the end to our analysts, Pori Costello from Ballinrobe and Adrian Hessian from Aghamore GAA Club, and to, of course, Micheál Kane, who's our video man, but also the man who has pioneered this live streaming in the Ballinrobe Club, and it's been a wonderful addition. Unfortunately, this evening it doesn't look like it's going to be marked by a victory, as Aghamore enjoy that 6-point lead. Joseph Burke, Phelan Riley, David Killeen gone long. Donald Vaughan is inside now. James Quinn Doney doesn't get there. David Kinney has it, and he there's a card, I'd say, coming for David O'Connor. David, who was the man who went down when Tom Ford got the card earlier on, and I think he might be following that well-worn path to the sideline, David O'Connor, to cap a disappointing evening for Ballinrobe. 1:14 to 1 goal and 8 points. We're in the final minute of normal time. There will be a few minutes added on, but it doesn't look like there'll be enough to dramatically alter the situation. Walter Loftus is the player on for David O'Connor. Shane Biggins and Alan Freeman clashing there. Alan Freeman is still nursing himself afterwards, and Shane felt it as well, and a free for Aghamore, and I think another instance of dissent for Ballinrobe, and the referee is calling Darren McDonald, I think. Meanwhile, the clock ticks on. We're just going into injury time now, and I think that's a black card for Darren McDonald. Full time, Hollymount, Caramore 15, Swinford 2-7. That's close, Porrick. Two goals for Swinford, that was a close one. So, Aghamore, Robert Lyons. And they're playing down the clock now, Connor Lyons. That Cassidy, I think Keith Cassidy on the ball. Back to Connor Lyons, Darren Duffy, Jamie Tighe, David Kinney, Mark Finnerty, young minor player, is the man on for Darren McDonald. This is Mark's senior debut. And well blocked there by Eugene O'Malley. But it's all, I suppose, filling Aghamore's barrow now, Adrian. The longer it ticks along like that, the less dangerous of Ballinrobe pulling something out of the hat.
Yes, and in fairness to the Aghamore team, they stuck to their game plan. It didn't work against Cross Malina. It came up short against Ballintubber. But the same game plan was developed here tonight, and it came up trumps. And not only has it avoided relegation, but has been lucky enough to get them into the county senior quarterfinals as well.
It's a three-game competition, that's the thing about it. There's only four teams in it, but it can swing dramatically on the last day. And we've seen that today, because Aghamore had lost both games before today. They win today, and they make their way into the quarter-final, and it just shows you the value of not taking a beating from Aghamore or from Ballintubber, like Ballinrobe and Cross Malina got, which upsets your scoring average. So, Alan Freeman, 50 yards out. It's curling. Oh, that's majestic. That is quite something, Adrian.
1-4 from today from Alan. As they say, he plays a different role. He's a free taker, he's a ball winner, he's a worker around the middle. 1-4 today, unbelievable stuff again from Alan.
And he seems to benefit from that sort of more freedom out the field. He doesn't that constrained there.
On the Mayo teams, he's in around the edge of the square, and he has to win the ball. There's a lot of pressure on him, but he really can develop and really can open up here when he's out around the middle of the field.
Joseph Burke lets it in towards Matthew Burke. Donald Vaughan comes out as well. Donald making a serious effort to get the ball, just can't get there. Frustrating for him. Peter Welch. In fairness to Ballinrobe, Porrick, they've kept working to the end. The forwards are pressurising hard there.
Yeah, they keep working all right, but just not getting enough of scores, and just give the way, you know, to give the ball away a few times there when it was vital, and they paid the price. So
here we go. Shane Biggins intercepts. Another sign of a man who hasn't given up. We are in the 33rd minute. David Killeen. Back to Killian Welch, Donald Vaughan, Aghamore men all around him. They won't let him go free. Alan Freeman the closest. Paddy Finnegan there as well. Free for Donald Vaughan. Little bit of afters between Finnegan and Donald Vaughan. Perhaps discussing the price of a new range of shoes, perhaps, maybe.
Shoes or beef.
So, 14-yard free for Ballinrobe. James Quinn, I think, is the player standing over it. James kicks it quickly and kicks it wide, and it's all over. It's all over. The final whistle is gone. There's a little bit of afters. I don't think he'll come to much, though. And that's it here, Porrick, unfortunately, from this evening. 1-15 to 1-8. And Aghamore are the clear victors. No real disputing their superiority on this occasion. And small bits of afters, but it's fizzling out now. Porrick, you can't really dispute, I suppose, that overall Aghamore were the clearly superior side.
They were the best team on the day, and you know, they won the game, I suppose, like in the first half, because they didn't have any wide. Every chance they got, they put it over the bar, and you know, that's a sign of a good team. They worked hard around the middle of the field, they carried the ball well, and they killed it off when they got that goal in after half time there. You know, it really put the pressure on our lads, and that's it. The best team of the day, and you know, you have to hand it them.
Ballinrobe face relegation battle, but for Aghamore, Adrian, a bit of a Houdini job, although, as we said, nothing is decided until everything is decided in a group like this. But Aghamore were down after the first defeat, I know, to Cross Malina. They were leading right down the stretch, got caught, didn't beat up Ballintubber, came here today under pressure, and I've got a real dividend now with Aghamore, with Cross Malina being beaten by Ballintubber.
Yes, exactly, and even though they had no points coming into the group table today, there were still signs throughout the senior championship that they were very competitive. Ballintubber came to Aghamore last weekend, and it was all Aghamore in the first half of that, but two sucker punch goals set them back on their feet. So they showed signs throughout that they could compete with the best. Today they came to Ballinrobe, they stuck to their guns, stuck to their game plan, worked it up the middle, worked it through their ball carriers, and again came away with a 7-point victory. Commendations to Jimmy Lyons. He has taken this team on board. He has a junior team, he has a junior B team. He's doing an awful lot of work to develop football in Aghamore and keeping everyone on board, and that's lovely to see. And it just was worth for him to get his place in the county quarter final.
Am I right in saying that in both years he's had the team, he's got them to the quarter final?
Possibly now, you'd have to say someone more advanced in the club. But yes, last year they got to a quarter final, just came up short in the quarter final against Mitchell. Came in, hit a steamrolling Mitchell's along the way, which came up. You have to remember that in 2004 Aghamore won junior, 2008 they won intermediate and went to senior. They're 7 or 8 years now at senior, so they're experienced senior team, and they're looking all the time to move it on to the next level.
Okay, well, they took a good step in that direction this evening. Comfortable win in the end. It was competitive for a lot of the way, but a comfortable win in the end. Alan Freeman and Kenny Feeney really powerful in the middle of the field. Lots of other good performances as well. David Kenny, Darren Duffy, Fergal Boland as well, but lots of other ones as well. Cahill Freeman did his bit too. Was very dangerous. And that's it from Flanagan Park, Ballinrobe this evening. Thank you to Micheál Cain and to all our listeners around the world. Unfortunately, from a Ballinrobe perspective, it was to prove disappointing. We hope you enjoyed the broadcast, and hopefully the maroon and yellow will rise again. Best of luck to Aghamore in the remainder of the championship, and hopefully we will avoid relegation a little bit later on in the summer. So thank you very much. Over and out. Thank you.